2019 was actually a very tough year for South Africa generally, particularly if you consider that the GDP growth rate was very low.
And from a fiscal position, it is clear also that the government cannot solve this crisis on its own.
2019 was definitely a year of heightened activity for Metair and I think for the industry as a whole. Although a little bit of a suppressed market environment within which we needed to act.
It was very much a year of execution. In order for us to execute on our strategy of building out the investment experience that we had in Identity Partners to become a leading private equity fund manager with strong transformational credentials and impact investing focus.
We saw and still see large pools of capital sitting on the sidelines. Investors are being very selective to which deals to allocate capital.
I think we've seen fewer exits, fewer investments. And so what does that mean? I think really private equity professionals are really focused on what I call value creation.
From a regulatory perspective, the regulations did not abate. It was still a lot of plethora of new regulations. We saw the new fit and proper requirements come in South Africa in terms of the FASE Act.
A theme that I think got a lot of prominence in 2019 and certainly started before that was the theme of gender lens investing and focus on women. And we saw it kick off with initiatives certainly led by the DFIs. We saw the 2X challenge coming out and on the back of that we've also seen a lot of focus on gender and gender financing and gender lens investing.
For me, one of the great highlights of 2019, which is a perfect example of collaboration and commitment, was the initiation by SAFCA of the Fund Manager Development Program. I think that's an excellent way of the industry committing to a new generation of emerging fund managers. And the support that SAFCA received from the SA SME Fund and FNB also shows the strength when we come together to support and collaborate on these initiatives.
Private equity continues to outperform the listed space. It really shows the worth of private equity and the value of private equity. All of the strategies that we put in place, the long-term view that we take on these businesses that we invest in, starts bearing fruit in terms of the returns we're able to demonstrate through private equity in tough economic environments.
2020 is going to be a pivotal year for South Africa. As a country, our single greatest challenge is the performance and state of state-owned entities.
It is obviously still going to be tough in 2020. I think the experts are predicting a growth rate of less than 1%.
Metair has got a track record of providing a large amount of co-investment to its LPs and looking to partner to de-risk investments and collaborate with other GPs on transactions, which we've done in other geographies. And that we think should continue as a method of doing business in the continent.
It's not easy doing private equity on the continent. So collaboration from a funding perspective, collaboration on deals, so we're not competing and driving up returns and making it harder for us to get decent returns, but also collaboration on skills. And I think that's probably one of the biggest challenges that private equity has is skills and the shortage of skills, and collaborating and bringing skills together I think is again going to help us to deliver the returns that we need to for our LPs and investors.
I think there are a lot of good investment opportunities out there, and funds with access to capital that are able to make wise decisions will reap the rewards of taking the risk in 2020.
We're excited about 2020 because we see a lot of effort and dialogue around promoting transformation, diversity and inclusion in the industry, which is very important.
Private equity needs to commit to rolling up their sleeves, adding value, and through that value creation, the fruits will come in the years to come.
Private and public sectors need to work together. We need to connect, we need to collaborate, and we need to commit to making South Africa's SOEs great.